is going down right here. The Ghetto Mexican Podcast.
Hey, baby, it's going down right here in the Ghetto Mexican Podcast. You know what I'm saying? It's live, man. We in this bitch. I'm with my boy Baloo, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to let him give a little insight about himself so y'all can get to know who this cat is. You know what I'm saying? Live little homie, man. Go let him know what's up, Baloo. A little something about you, homie. Where they can find you. And you know what I'm saying? If they want some work, photography, you know, let the boys know the whole thing.
For sure, man. Well, you know, number one, I appreciate, you know, Ghetto Mexican Podcast for...
Y'all already know, homie.
For, you know, asking me to come through.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, I ran into y'all up there at the 713 deal, the 713 Inc. Deal. And, you know, I was just taking a couple shots. My boy, Space City Stoner,
right.
He had asked me to jump on a song, so I jumped on a song with him.
And that bitch was live, yeah, man. That one made me... Yeah. Who the fuck this nigga is?
Yeah. So we performed that hard, and then, you know, people that was there, they started reaching out to me, like, hey, bro, you know. So, you know, I really, music, rapping, bro, that's my first love, my passion. I've been doing
hip-hop,
freestyle.
Period.
I've been doing freestyle battles, bro.
Word?
Back when Cornbreads
was alive,
you know what I'm saying? Like,
old school.
With DJ Triple X up there.
Yeah,
bro.
Yeah.
All that, bro.
Word,
I've been doing this music for a long time, but... Anyway, man, I kind of got away from that, man. You know, been down, did some time, came home. My homeboy was already doing the videos, you know what I'm saying? And he kind of introduced me to the game. So, man, I went and got me a camera and just started
doing
messing around, doing my thing, man. And ever since, man, I've just been smashing, man. So it's been about a year with that, man. And but, yeah, definitely, man, you can hit me up at Baloo, shot this. BALOO.SHOT.THIS at Baloo Shot This on Instagram. You can go to at Baloo Shot This on YouTube. I just started that up. But yeah, man, just trying to get a feel of this different part of the game.
Man.
I've been doing the rap for a long time, bro. From doing shows to having to set everything up, to having to get the dancers, to get everybody to pull up as a unit. It's a headache, you know what I'm saying?
Shit, you telling me, bro.
Yeah, bro.
I totally feel that.
Yeah, so I've done all that, man. Yeah. I just like working this camera, bro. I like, you know, working the camera, doing my little edits, man.
Hey, the boss cold with it, man. Cold with it, man. I might have to get a little learning session with you,
man,
because I'm, you know, with the podcast, and my boy live with it, too,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, man, for sure, for sure.
Yeah, so what got you into it, bro? Like, what motivated you to get you in the game?
With the music or the video?
I say, what came first, music, right?
Well, the music was first, yeah. The music was first, man. You know, coming up, all my homeboys, they used to freestyle, you know what I'm
word,
saying?
Word.
And I couldn't, so I asked the boys, hey, bro, man, show me how to freestyle, show me how to freestyle. And nobody would show me, so, man, my mom bought me a karaoke, bro. She bought me the karaoke machine and with a little tape, and I used to just put instrumentals on and just go, bro, and then I started having people come over, and then I started doing freestyle battles like Majestic Hall. I don't know if you know about that, but it's on the Southwest side. They used to do freestyle battles and then Cornbreads and all that. And that was my thing at first, was doing battles. I like confrontation. I like getting in your face and talking down. And, you know,
talking that really,
and,
spitting the lyrics.
Yeah, and it's just freestyle off the dome. Now a lot of people say freestyle, but it's wrote down, which is cool, you know what I'm saying, whatever, but we just known for going off the dome, you know what I'm saying?
We'll tell the city of freestyle,
yeah,
baby.
You know what I'm saying? And but anyway, man, I got into that, was doing the music for a while, messed with a couple groups, got messed over by some groups.
Yeah.
You know, I was with Bellway Records for a little while back in the day.
That's a fact, y'all ready.
I was messing with Lions Den back in the day with the music.
Yeah, Lions Den.
Yeah, man, so I did that, and like I said, man, being involved in the streets, man, I never put any time into the music, you know what I'm saying? Like, I do freestyle battles, but I wasn't in the studio, like, trying to put out mixtapes or albums. So, long story short, you know, I ended up in the streets, blah, 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 did time, got out. But now this time, it's like, I love the music, bro. I want to rap and all that, but I just do it as a hobby now, man. Now I'm behind that lens, man. I got a passion for it.
Shit, speaking of lens, yeah, you got a video out you featured with somebody.
Yeah,
you said
man.
It was on the
I got so... The video is called Made Me. It's by K-Dash, featuring myself. And it's definitely a dope video, man. Y'all check the visuals out, man.
As a matter of fact, we're going to take a break right now, and we're going to check out the video. Y'all check it out. Y'all comment on the bottom. Y'all say, what's up? Y'all need some work? Holler at my boy. But we're going to take a break right now. Y'all check out this video. What's the video game, man? Let them know what it is again.
The name of the video is Made Me by K-Dash featuring the Ox.
It's going down. Y'all tune in. We'll be right back. Ghetto Mexican Podcast, baby.
Hey, it's going down right here. Ghetto Mexican Podcast.
Ox, what kind of name's Ox?
It's Jamaican.
There ain't nothing about you that looks Jamaican, boy.
I just cut my dreads off yesterday.
Oh, yeah? Okay, let's cut to the bullshit, man.
What you got? You got some water?
Didn't you get enough of that on the swim over here? Okay. Who's this, and then we can talk about some water.
Who's what?
Who is the man in both of those pictures?
This black dude right here? Kind of looks like you, man.
Okay. You gonna be a smart ass. You know what that looks like to me?
No.
That looks about like 10 years, and this looks about 10 years.
Oh, yeah? Is that like 12?
I know you can't count, but that's 20.
What are you asking? What's your question?
It's my question is, who is that?
I said you, man.
I guess our business is done here, bro.
Yeah. Hey, just go get my lawyer, man.
Focus, baby. CNG. K-Dash.
I was taught to have patience, it's all about perfect timing. I'm only buying white, no yellow and blue diamonds. It's funny how these lames come around when they see you shining, but you was taking penitentiary chances while you was grinding. Yeah, I'm sharp, some like your lining. I let that iron do the work, never be testifying. But hustle in my comfort zone, never feel petrified. And if your name in that black and white, me and my team, we ride.
Hey, what's up, boy, man? Hey, I called you up here for a good ass reason, man.
Oh, yo, what's that?
Say, man, I ain't gonna lie, bro. I just found out who snitched on Ox, man.
Shit, how we gonna resolve that? We can't have the snitching shit, bro.
Man, I'm already thinking, man, it got on Alpha.
Yeah,
and it's simple, you know.
I'm with that, we just can't let Ox find out.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a bit. Say no more.
Alright.
You can tell by these bars, I ain't rocking the skinnies. OG, granddaddy, you ain't blowing it with me. I just came back from Denver, she got blow on the titty. And I be halfway around the globe while you capping your city, nigga. What you know about pointers when it come to diamonds, nigga? What you know about corners when it come to grinding, nigga? What you know about metaphors when rhyming, nigga? I can put you on, ain't all about the shining. Now these hoes wanna fuck now, no lean up in my cup now. My ass sit on Buck Howe, I keep that pistol tucked. She tried to sell me a premium just so I can fuck now. I'm laughing at her ass, I told her silly hoe to duck down. So what now? I'm flexing with these bars again. Savage hearted what I wear and they applauding him. I'm trying to stretch my money just like an accordion. K-Dash, I'm just trying to build my heart.
Hey, what's up, bro?
What's up, bro?
Hey, you remember little homie I was at the mall with the other day?
Yeah, what about him?
Yeah, bro, man, I just got word they dying that bar, man. So I need you to come to the funeral with me, bro. Gotta pay my respect, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, this recent?
Yeah, it just happened, bro.
Alright, just let me know when.
Alright.
Savage hearted, crossed the chest. Nah, this ain't a cardigan. Took my time to the chin. Told the DA, no bargaining. No, please, so please. Miss me with the arguments. I may leave some ambassador. Mr. Turner, where's my monument? Been out here crashing these mics since they live middle. Went against the grain and put the leaf up in the middle. I went from selling crack to weed in the Skittles to rocking out with God. There's no need for a pistol. As I read these epistles, back up in the hood, man, back to back. So there's no need for a hook, man. They mistake, meekness, fool. weakness and get left speechless. When it comes through and sweeps up, OG ain't teach us. We learn the hard way, way before y'all was channel sets and parvay. Boys get hit doing B's, kids forced to suffer, and a child's mother just forced to get tougher. You see me, I'm trying to break that cycle. You can't fake it to make it when them little ones need diapers. Too many times I've had to hold up lighters for one of my homies that gave his life up trying to get his stripes up. I hear an A-leaf, no way to persuade me that this game ain't shady. When you're on T-lady, keep a 380 for the lazy. You know what's amazing? I'm proud to say it made me.
Man, we back again, man. Hey, that video was live, man. Like I said, drop them comments on the bottom, and man, y'all, hey, run them numbers up for my boy, man. Hey, so like you were saying, man, you do a lot of the videography and stuff too. Like, who have you, like, you know, photographed or did videos for, or you know what I'm saying?
So I've messed with a couple of people from my neighborhood, from A-Leaf.
Yeah.
As far as on the videos, man, you know, done a couple of videos for them. I'm actually working on a video for Rizé.
What's up, Rizé, baby?
Yeah, I'm working on a video for him.
Waiting for him.
I was supposed to been knocked that out, man, but I just been doing a million and one things. But mostly, man, I've been working with this catering company, man, called TVE Catering. Shout out to them, man. TVE is dope.
Bird.
They're a catering company, man. They're also from my side of town, man, and you know, I've been knowing them for a while, and they doing a lot of dope stuff, like, you know what I'm saying?
So you're doing commercials then,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, trying to
super
trying to
dope, man.
Yeah, trying to do more.
See, that's what I
stuff.
Mean by expanding, just not the rap. You got to you gotta be a self-entrepreneur. You got to think outside the box. Hey, man, and that's what's up, man. I like that.
Yeah, dope. Man. So, you know, I've done little commercials here. I don't know if you've heard of Tropical Daiquiris.
Yeah.
Did a commercial for them. But yeah, mostly with this catering company, bro. They've been doing a lot of dope stuff. They actually catered Go DJ High C.
They
catered his wedding, and you know, I did the video and photography for the catering company. That was a dope, you know, dope wedding, bro. They had
laid out.
Yeah, man. Which I got a video for that too, which I'll probably let y'all check out.
That's what's up, man.
But yeah, man, I just been trying to get into more commercial stuff, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? As far as like the rap game, like you said, expand beyond it, bro. It's a million and one ways to do it.
Hey, man.
Rap game is just one way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Same thing I tell these dudes.
It's just like opening to a bunch of doors. You just gotta.
Yeah, keep man. It's too many ways, man. The same thing I tell these dudes, man. Cause I mess around still. I go to the prisons too, bro.
Yeah.
I'm going
back. No shit.
Yeah.
That's dope,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah.
Cause I was finna ask you right now. Since you like you yourself entrepreneur, like what would you tell the young comers that who's seeking the same route as you? I mean,
yeah,
you know
man, man, you know what I'm saying? It's funny because today I was supposed to speak at an intermediate school to a young football team. I was supposed to speak to them, you know what I'm saying, about, you know, just they told me come speak about whatever you want to say, bro. Like we like your story. From where you were to where you're at now, we want you to speak to the kids.
Well,
because of the water situation,
so
they sent the email saying, hey, man,
we had to cut it short.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So, but anyways, back to what you said about what would I say to the kids
or
the younger generation, man, like I was going to tell them, you know, they're a football team, so what happens when you go offsides? You got to go back 5 yards, right? And it's the same thing in life, bro. Whenever you get out of position of your position, you got your own position. He has his, I have mine. Whenever I get out of position, it knocks me back, bro, or it gets me off track.
You ain't lying,
so,
bro.
You know what I'm saying? It's best to know what your lane is, stay in your position, bro, and you continue to progress. I'm not trying to go back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, and that's what it's about, bro. Like, man, too many times, bro, especially being with other people. That's why I rock one deep, man. Anywhere I go, that's I come deep, well here. Yeah, I drove up down there.
Ball kick is a real deep game right here, man.
Yeah, man, I be one deep, bro. Because most of the time, bro, I'm telling you, I listen to it on the music too, bro. Like, dudes say some things, and I'm like, man, bro, I can't believe I should think like that, because it's like that.
Yeah,
I might be with you, and he called me a hoe, and then, hey, fool, you gonna let that nigga call you a hoe? Boom, here I am, pop, 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 probably kill him, he killed
me. Grain,
there it is, I'm gone.
Yeah,
like, I'm locked up or I'm dead. All because this man said, you gonna let him call you?
Yeah.
Man, you know what, bro, I do me, I ride by myself. I go everywhere by myself.
Trust
even
me,
if I
bro,
step out, bro.
These last couple of days, I've been having fucked up situations, man, but I kind of swallow my pride, bro, but you know, that don't make you no hoe. That make you a grown-ass man with knowledge and wisdom and know what he got in life to push forward.
Because
a nigga that don't give a fuck is a motherfucker who got nothing, man.
And
I got too much to lose, and I know Big Daddy do too, so we just trying to lead the young to the right path, man, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you can't, I learned that in prison, man. I just talked about this on Facebook, like, you can't catch everything that people throw up. You know what I'm saying?
You be one catching motherfucker.
Exactly, bro. You, man. And I had to learn that, bro. You know, because I went in there at 18, and you know, every time somebody, well, what's up? Let's get out there.
You gotta get out.
Every time, and it was like, bro, I'm the one losing. You know what I'm saying? And like you said, it's to another clown that has nothing to lose. You know, you
straight
got
like that.
You know, you got no kids, no family, no car, no nothing. I got all that, bro. I got a daughter. You know what I'm saying? I got my little business going. I got a regular 9-to-5. I got a lot of stuff going on, bro. I'm not finna smoke it behind you.
Yeah.
You know, as long as you stay out of this space right here,
give me
we're good.
Feet.
Yeah. As long as you stay out of this space, we're
real
good.
Tough, man.
I say this all the time.
Yeah.
Look, bro, I ain't got nothing. Just don't let me find out you ain't got nothing.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get on your road.
For real, man. Yeah, only bro. Right here in the Ghetto Mexican Podcast.
Yeah,
you gonna hear the real, man.
Yeah,
so,
man.
What do you do, like, you know, for your exit time, and you know, when like, oh, well, I know you talk to the youth, you say you do that.
Yeah.
And
I do that, man. I go to the prisons, man. I go back and I speak to them dudes.
Man, that's super dope, bro. That's what's up,
go
man.
Go back and speak to them boys, man. Because, you know, when I was down there, I remember people coming to talk to us while I was down there. And I'm like, man, one day I'm going to do the same thing. And that's what I do, bro. I go back, I get them dudes hope, I let them know of everything that's going on in my life, bro. Because if God can bless me the way he's been blessing me, bro, there's no way why he can't bless another dude coming out of penitentiary.
Amen,
you know what I'm saying,
bro. That's deep.
You know, my boy just got out, man. Was gone for a long time.
Word.
And he's been having it hard, bro. He got tattoos on his face, head, everywhere, bro.
Yeah,
and he's been having it hard. He's like, man, bro, I ain't been able to find a job. So, you know, I'm like, let me work on something. My brother called me today.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, hey, bro, I need somebody to work the forklift. Long story short, I said, look, bro, I got this dude. He's a good dude. But, bro, when you see him, he said, man, send him, bro. Send him over there.
And you know, don't be the ones at work, man, because they go through their life and they tire their life and they really trying to find a way out. And they realize, like, man, they now they want to.
Yeah.
And you dumb people right there, you got to help, man.
They
you know what I'm saying? You got to help, man. They've been through the bottom. Once you hit that bottom, bro, there's no other way up. But back down, bro.
Hey, bro, watch. I'm going to call him later on. That's exactly what I told him.
Yeah.
I was like, look, bro, the job only starts you at this. But, bro, when you're at the bottom, the only place to go is up, bro. So just work it. You know what I'm saying? They gave you a chance.
What's your homeboy's name?
The one that that just got the job?
Yeah.
Kilo. His name is Kilo.
Hey, I salute you, Kilo, man. Keep pushing, homie. You know what I'm saying? You're a testimony, homie. You know what I'm saying? And singly, homie, you know, only gets better, man. Come fuck with me on my podcast, homie. Like I said, it only gets better, man. You got a good down-ass homie right here looking out for you, man.
Yeah, man. So that's just it, man. And then, you know, my free time, which I barely have any, bro, I'm working on my camera, you know what I'm saying?
Just and then not that the kids.
You know what I'm saying?
You got to make time for the wife.
Yeah,
man,
bro, balance. That's the biggest thing is balance, bro.
Yeah.
Man, because if you don't. You know, if you don't give time to this, if you give too much time to this, you're neglecting that.
Yeah.
If you're giving this much time, you're neglecting that. So it's like,
ain't enough time in the day,
bro. It ain't, bro.
It ain't.
But you know, there's a million and one people out here making it, bro.
Yeah, so.
Now, with the same 24 hours in the day, so ain't no reason, bro. You know, a lot of people with excuses, oh, they won't hire me, or they want this, or they, nah, bro. Get your ass and go get something till you get what you want. You know what I'm saying?
I don't care.
You know, somebody told me in prison, he's like, look, bro, go work at McDonald's when you get out. Swallow your pride. Work at McDonald's. get you a job, then figure out where they get their meat from, where they get their toilet paper from. Mm-hmm. Figure out the business, and then one day, man, when you stack your money up, you can open up yours. That's what it's about right now, bro. Straight it's about up. Working for you, bro. Like,
learning process. Man, you do more of what you love and less of what you hate, man.
Yeah, straight up, man. So, yeah, bro, I'm just on a whole different tip than
hey, I truly support, man.
A lot of people, bro. I'm telling you, I've lost it all twice.
Yeah.
And I'm putting it back together. I ain't trying to lose it again.
I know
bro.
That's right, brother.
That shit is whack.
I know that's right, brother.
To have this and then you fall lose back it, down. Bro, and you got to come out to nothing. Come out to burn the rise, staying in people's house, being a burden. You know what I'm saying? Nah, bro.
Tiptoeing to the fridge,
right? Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I know, man.
You know, I'm done with that, bro.
Don't want to be broke no more.
Man. Nah,
hey, each one teach one. Raise your rasa or raise your people or whatever it takes, man.
Sure, yeah.
You know, strength in numbers, man. You know what I'm saying? And on that being said, man, I truly appreciate you fucking with me on the Ghetto Mexican Podcast. I reached out to you and I'm glad you came and hollered at me. You had some good shit to tell to the people out there, the youth, and you know, some OGs too. You know what I'm saying? And I appreciate that, homie. You know, tell these folks, hey, my boy does cameras, he does weddings, he does commercials, he does rap videos. And my nigga raps.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, man, whatever y'all want, man, holler at my boy. Tell them where they reach you up. Facebook,
yeah, man. So, once again, man, on Instagram, it's @BalooShotThis. My boy put the info on there. On Instagram, YouTube, it's @BalooShotThis. And, yeah, man, like, hit me up, man. I work with all budgets. You know, I ain't going to lie to you. Everybody about money. Don't get it twisted.
Yeah.
But I'm not out here trying to get rich off of this. I'm not trying to rape nobody.
Right.
What you got, let's work with it. You can't do this, okay. We'll work something out. You know what I'm saying? Man, bro, I just love this. And I love looking out because I know he blessed me whenever I bless his people.
Bro.
So, man, just, you know, hit me, bro. Like, hit me for whatever. Pictures, weddings, whatever. We'll work something out, man. You know what I'm saying?
Finance.
Finance, trade. The barter system.
They gotta make a song. And we gotta do a video.
Hey. Let's do it.
So,
man.
Like, who would you like to fuck with in the rap game? Like, since you know what I'm saying? Like,
man, honestly, bro.
Yeah, who you waiting for to call you that? I wanna do it.
Well, you know, one person that I'm gonna do a song with.
Yeah.
We already got the track, and it's been in the making for years, bro. But like I said, I was in the streets playing games.
Yeah.
Oh, shout out to my boy Sleek from the Airbrush store at Sharp Time Mall at Plaza Americas.
Sleek?
You know what I'm saying? So he got the track, and we're going to do a song with K. Reno, man.
Ooh,
you know, that's Big Bro, man.
Yeah.
I've been rocking with Big Bro for many years.
The story,
man,
of the Black Book.
Yeah, man, for many, many years.
Coming
like
out, dog, and COD.
He been told me, I got you, bro. Just get the track ready. I got you. I'll record my verse. I've been playing, bro.
Fascinating.
Like, you know, I'm back, and my verbals are definitely up.
Yeah.
So, man, it's time to get in the ring with
Big
Bro, man.
Yeah.
Just drop another collab, man.
Yeah,
you know, shout out
legendary.
To
He got
Space
a book
City.
Coming out.
Yeah, shout out to Space City.
What's up, Space City?
Hardcore, you know
Hardcore,
what I'm saying?
My G.
Song, man. I appreciate y'all boys. Cause
done.
Y'all motivated me to get back in this music, man.
Yeah, and, good people,
you
bro.
Know, so, man, yeah, let's rock out, man. Anybody want me to come do a feature too, man? Hey, let's do it, man.
Yeah.
I come up with a hook or whatever, man.
I'm gonna need you on my shit, baby.
Yeah, let's do it, bro.
I'm gonna
need
you on
my
shit, yeah. So, yeah, man, you're my boy, man. Righteous homie, you know what I'm saying? Stiff too, man, you know what I'm saying? But humble, man, nigga.
For sure.
And about his company, his business, and his motivating others and helping the youth. You done heard it all right here, man, the Ghetto Mexican Podcast. So, y'all stay tuned. Let them know who you is again, boy, because they're going to see more of my G right here, man.
Yeah, man. At Baloo Shot This, man. Everybody call me Baloo, man. A lot of people from prison know me as Ox. So, Baloo the Ox, man.
There you go.
Man, hit me up. This work.
Only right here in the Ghetto Mexican Podcast. The Stiff and the Trill and the Righteous, baby. It's going down. Peace.
Hey, it's going down right here in the Ghetto Mexican Podcast.